Everyone, this is also another revision topic from GI system, and the topic for today that will be on helminthiasis. Okay, so I've already done this topic in the class, and this is just a revision class. Okay, so first of all is helminthiasis. Okay, so by the word helminthiasis, remember helminth. It comes from the word helminth. Is helminth ka matlab hai worms. Okay, so there are so many types of worms that can transport into our GI system. Okay, so when these worms, they enter into our GI system, into the stomach, into the intestine, in small intestine, large intestines, they cause infection. Okay, and they try to damage the intestinal wall. Okay, so there are so many types of worms or helminths, we call it as. So the first type is human whipworm. So you can see everyone. I hope everyone can see the screen. Suppose screen dikh raha hai. Second years. Yes, ma'am, dikh raha hai.
Yes, okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So the first type of helminths or the first type of worms is a human whipworm. So you can see it is like this. It is coiled. Okay, they are curly and they are very curvy also. So this is a human whipworm. Then there is another type of worm which is called as ascaris. Okay, it is like this and it is yellow orange in color. Then we also have another type of worm that is pinworm. Okay, it is like a pin. Okay, so the edges hai, ye jo tip hai, it is like a pin, very sharp. So this is a pinworm. Then also the other type of worm is liver fluke. Okay, so you can see here it is maroon in color. Okay, so this is a liver fluke. Then we have pork tapeworm, okay, which is green in color, and you can see it is a very long worm. Okay, so this is a pork tapeworm. And we also have another type of worm that is bovine tapeworm. So in bovine tapeworm, you can see it has two eyes, and the face structure is like this, and the body structure, okay, it is totally a little bit similar to pork tapeworm, but it is a little bit bigger. Okay, pork tapeworm is longer, it is very long, and bovine tapeworm, it is a little bit bigger. Okay, bigger in size. So these are the type of helminths. Okay, so when these helminths or when these worms, they enter into your GI system, when they enter into our esophagus, then they go down into the stomach, then to the intestines, and then they cause infection. Okay, so that is about helminths. Okay, now the disease condition, it is called as helminthiasis. So helminthiasis, it is a micro parasitic disease of humans and animals. Ye sirf human beings ko affect nahi karte, lekin even in animals also. Okay, you will always find worms inside the animal's GI system. So helminthiasis is a micro parasitic disease of humans and animals in which a part of the body is infested with parasitic worms, or we call it as helminths, such as pinworm, roundworm, or tapeworm, okay, or any other types of worms which will infect the patient's GI system. So these worms, they stay inside the GI system and spreads into the liver and the other lungs. So first of all, what do? They enter into the GI system. Okay, it can be in the stomach, it can be in the small intestine, in the large intestine. Okay, and then from there, the worms can go and transfer into the other organs of the body that is which are very close to the GI system. It can be in the liver, or it can be in the it can go into the kidneys also, it can go into the pancreas, okay, and the nearby organs. Okay, Okay, so when these worms will enter into the organs, they will cause infection and there will be many complications. So is this clear about the definition? Is there any doubt here? Anybody has any doubt with the definition? Chaya, Natasha?
No, ma'am.
So this is a picture, okay? So you can see there is a worm which is inside the inside the stomach. Okay, so the worms can be of different type. It can be a tapeworm, bog tapeworm. It can be a human whipworm, or it can be a liver fluke, or it can be any type of worms. So the causative agent, what is the cause of helminthiasis? Okay, the main cause of helminthiasis is the helminths, which we call it as worms. Okay, so there are different types of worms. Like I said, first of all, there is a roundworm. Okay, in roundworm, there are two types, which we call it as intestinal nematodes and larval tissue nematodes. Okay, so these are the two types under roundworms. Okay, so they are round in shape. Okay, they are not like this. They are basically circle or round in shape. Then we have tapeworm. Tapeworm, they are found in the intestine or the larva in the tissues. Okay, so tapeworm here, you can see it can be a bovine tapeworm or it can be a pork tapeworm. Then we have fluke. Okay, these are the hermaphrodites with an exception of blood flukes. They are found in the blood vessels. Okay, they can be found in the arteries. They can be found in the veins. Can be present in the intestines, in large intestine or small intestine, depend karte hain. They are also found in the biliary tract and they are also found in the lungs. Okay, so these are the flukes. Okay, so these are the different types of worms. So how do these worms, they get into the GI system? How they infect the GI system of the human body? So the mode of transmission is, it is transmitted through two types of routes. Ek hai fecal oral route. Okay, so fecal, whenever you see fecal, remember stool or relating to any bowel content. Okay, so fecal here meaning stool. If the child or any person is passing stool, and if they do not maintain hand hygiene, they are not washing their hands after passing stool, okay, and even in open defecation, okay, open area mein stool pass karna, and then they do not wash their hands, okay, so with those hands, you have cleaned the perineal area, and then after that, with those hands, they are not washing their hands, and then they are touching their mouth. So by that way also, you can get the infection. Okay, so by that way, the worms can enter into the mouth and it will go into the GI system. Okay. Then second is, you can see by the fecal oral route also, it can be because of the house fly. You know, house fly hai ya mosquito hai, any other type of flies. Okay, so if person is passing stool in the open area, okay, field mein, okay, so wahan pe house flies honge, hai na? So there will be insects, there will be house flies, so they can carry a small amount of the feces or the stool, and they can can spread here and there. So that also can lead to the transmission of the worms inside the body. Then into the crops, okay, into the open defecation, isliye abhi open defecation is being stopped because of the causation of helminthiasis. So we do not want worms to be inside the patient's stomach, okay, so we have to avoid open defecation. Okay, so if we are doing open defecation and then the stool will go into the crops, it will go into the soil, and then from there only other people are eating the food that are grown in that crop, they are grown in that field, okay, so in that soil. So by that also, the eggs of the worms, they can be transmitted to the patient's body. So this is fecal oral route for Ascaris, Trichuris and hookworm. Okay, so fecal oral route is the main mode of transmission, and the other transmission is the skin penetration for hookworm. Okay, so if there is any injury in your legs, if there is any injury in any part of the body, okay, especially your legs, okay, and you are not wearing slippers, okay, so you are not wearing slippers, there is some cracks in your legs, in your feet, sole, jo feet ki sole hai, wahan pe cracks hai, okay, injury hai, and you are not wearing slipper, you are going out in the into the field, okay, without wearing any slippers, without any wearing any shoes. So what happened is wahan pe jo field mein ya jo soil mein worms hai, they can, this hook worm, they can go inside the patient's legs. Okay, they can enter the patient's legs through that crack or through that injury inside the patient's legs. So by that, by this mode, the worms can enter into the patient's body. Okay, so these are the two modes of transmission. One is the fecal oral route and the other is skin penetration. Okay, is this clear with everyone? Kisi ko doubt hai?
No, ma'am.
So now coming to the signs and symptoms. So if there is any worms, okay, if any worms, they enter into patient's GI system, okay, if it enters into the mouth, it will go down to the esophagus, then the worms, they can go down more and more deep into the stomach and into the intestines, large intestines, small intestines, then it can cause infection. So the signs and symptoms are, number one, patient can have abdominal pain. Okay. Then number two, there can be diarrhea also. Patient can have fever because of the infection. Okay. Fatigue, tiredness, weakness. There can be itching all over the body, itching in the abdomen. Then patient can have GI inflammation. Okay, where the intestinal walls, the wall of the intestine, they can be inflamed because of the action of the worms. Okay, the worms are causing infection in our stomach or in our GI system. So the walls can be inflamed. Then patient can have weight loss because of excessive diarrhea. Then dehydration because of excessive diarrhea and anorexia, that is, does not have the appetite to eat. Okay, so these are the signs and symptoms of helminthiasis. Then diagnostic test. Okay, so the important diagnostic test is the stool test, or we call it as the ova parasite stool test. Okay, so the diagnosis is made by finding the characteristic eggs in the stool by direct smear or by concentration method. Okay, so there are two types of method. Either by direct smear, we are we take a small sample of the stool and then we are smearing on the glass strip, and then we are identifying under the microscope to check for any eggs of the worms. Okay, jo worms ki eggs hai, we have to identify that. Then we can also do by concentration method. Okay, so concentration method is by putting some dye. Okay, by putting some contrast dye or putting some color. Okay, so first of all, we have to collect the stool sample. Okay, we can collect it in a container. Okay, or we can take it in a test tube. Okay, then we have to, second step is centrifuge separates the parasites and the ova. So we have to do this process, which is called as centrifuge. So this process, kya karte hain ye? जो ओवा है, जो एग्स है, उसको सेपरेट करते हैं फ्रॉम द पैरासाइट. देन द सैंपल इज एडेड टू द स्लाइड विद अ कॉन्ट्रास्ट डाई. देन आफ्टर दैट वी आर पुटिंग द कॉन्ट्रास्ट डाई, वी आर पुटिंग अ कलर. ओके, सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट कॉन्ट्रास्ट डाई वी आर गोइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई द एग्स. ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई द एग्स ऑफ द पैरासाइट, और वी आर गोइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई द एग्स ऑफ द वर्म्स. ठीक है, सो दिस इज अंडर द माइक्रोस्कोप. Okay, without the microscope, we are not able to identify the eggs of the worms. Okay, so this is the ova parasite stool test. Okay, so this is the diagnostic test. Then after that, after we have diagnosed, we are confirmed that there is some worms. Okay, there are worms inside the patient's stomach. Okay, so what will be the medical management? Okay, so I think everyone has, in their childhood, everyone has taken this tablet. We call it as albendazole. Okay, so albendazole, it is a broad spectrum benzimidazole. This is a category. Okay? So the medicine name is albendazole. So albendazole and mebendazole, they are the first line of treatment for treating any worm infection. Okay, so if there is any worms, it can be because of roundworm or tapeworms, then we can give tablet albendazole. Okay, so the dose here, it is 400 mg. Okay, so albendazole tablet, this is the generic name. The brand name or the chemical name, it can come in the name of worm myth 400, or it can come in the name of Zentel also. Okay, so only one tablet is present in one strip, okay, and the dose is 400 mg. Okay, so this is the main medical management, the first line of treatment. Okay, so if if anybody complains, or if anybody saying that it has been confirmed with worms in their stomach or worms in the GI system, then always advise for albendazole tablet. Okay, then the mass deworming in schools. So in schools, mostly in children. Okay, children mein, children, they are very active, and they have outdoor activity. Okay, say so they touch the soil, they touch mud. Okay, so they are at a higher risk of getting helminthiasis. Okay, so the health management, they have organized that there should be a mass deworming in the schools. Okay, in schools they have mass deworming, and the medicines that they give to the children in schools, that is albendazole, mebendazole, levamisole, and pyranthel. Okay, so these are some of the medicines that can can destroy the worms, and then the worms can come out from the stool. Okay, so this is the mass deworming process in school. Then coming to the surgical management. Okay, so if any complications of helminthiasis, so if the worms, they are damaging, or they are destroying the lining of the stomach, okay, and if they are destroying or damaging the tissues and the lining of the intestinal wall, okay, so that can lead to many complications. It can lead to injury, it can lead to bleeding, okay, intestinal bleeding, it can lead to intestinal injury, it can lead to infection, inflammation. So it can also lead to intestinal obstruction. Okay, so there can be obstruction in the intestines, so that will obstruct the digested food to flow into the large intestine. So this is another complication, and if there is any intestinal obstruction, agar koi obstruction hota hai intestines mein, if it is obstructing the flow of the digested foods, then it is an emergency. Then an emergency surgery should be done. Okay, so the affected area where there is infection, where there is a damage in the tissues of the lining of the intestinal wall, us area ko hume remove karna. Okay, so this is an emergency surgery. Then very important topic, that is the prevention and control. Okay, so how can we prevent a patient from having worms in their body? Number one is, okay, so these are the measures. So the first is the sanitary measure. Okay, so we have to avoid open air defecation. Yes, so we should, especially in rural areas, we always have to suggest for construction of toilets in their house. You know, there should be a toilet, okay, there should be a commode, and there should be proper water supply to the to the washroom or to the toilet. And we should educate the people in the rural area, in the village area, not to do open air defecation, not to pass stool in the open area, okay, or not to pass stool in the fields or in the soil. Okay, so this should be educated. Then proper sanitation, proper hand washing should be done after passing stool. Okay, hand wash should be there. Hand wash should be performed with soap and water. Okay, there should be proper supply of water. There should be soap availability, and educate the children not to play with the soil or not to play with the mud, because by touching the soil, by touching the infected soil, where that can lead to transmission of worms inside the body. So sanitary measures is very important, okay, and number two is health education. So we have to educate the people how to maintain food hygiene, okay, the jo bhi vegetables hain, okay, that they are getting from the field, or any food which is being prepared should be cooked properly, okay, and the water that they are using should be boiled. Okay, before drinking any water, you should boil it properly. Okay, it should be filtered properly, and okay, so that is safe drinking water from a safe source. Okay, so there should be filtered water. The water should be boiled. अच्छे से उसको boil करना है, फिर पीना है. Then the whatever food you are making at home, it should be cooked properly. Okay, and whatever vegetables you are getting from the field, it should be washed properly. Okay, so these are some of the education we can give to the patient. Then third is some personal hygiene, how to maintain yourself. Okay, every individual is independent, okay, and should be responsible for maintaining their own hygiene. So after passing stool or after passing urine, you should wash your hands. Okay, before touching any meal, before eating food, you should wash your hands. After eating food, after touching the food also, you should wash your hands. Okay, then avoid biting of nails. Okay, so some people, both girls and boys, they have a tendency to bite their nails. Okay, jab bahut tension mein hote, exam tension ya koi bhi stress mein hota hai, so they are biting their nails. So that can that is a very bad habit. You should not bite your nails, you should not suck your thumb or your fingers. Okay, because we never know ki ye jo fingers hai, ye jo nails hai, ye kahan pe humne touch kiya, which is dirty, which is infected. Okay, so we should never bite our nails, we should never suck our thumb or our fingers. Then always wear slippers. Okay, whenever you have to go inside the washroom, whenever you go inside the toilet, you always have to wear slippers. Or when you are going to the field, ठीक है, खेत में जाना है, कुछ काम है, वेजिटेबल्स लेना है, ठीक है, तो यू हैव टू वेयर योर स्लीपर्स. ओके, शुड नॉट वॉक बेयर फुट. ओके, शुड वेयर योर स्लीपर्स, और यू कैन वेयर सैंडल्स और योर शूज. ओके, एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इवन एट होम ऑल्सो यू शुड ऑलवेज पुट स्लीपर्स टू गो इनसाइड द टॉयलेट. ओके, डिफरेंट स्लीपर्स टू गो इनसाइड द टॉयलेट एंड डिफरेंट स्लीपर्स टू वेयर एट होम इनसाइड द हाउस. Okay, so you have to maintain personal hygiene. Okay, so the prevention here is very important. Number one is personal hygiene, how to maintain yourself. Number two is the sanitation. Okay, how to take care of the nearby areas, and how to maintain sanitation, how to maintain cleanliness, and the third is health education. Okay, and number four is deworming masks. Okay, that is in school. Okay, schools, jo public schools hai, government school hai, okay, private school also, there should be deworming program where they should give tablet albendazole to children if they are having worms in their stomach. Okay, so this is a very important program, you can say a very important program, so that ye jo helminthiasis hai, ye jo iska incidence hai, it should be reduced. Okay, so this is, so this was about helminthiasis or the disease condition where there are presence of worms in our GI system. So is this clear with helminthiasis? Kisi ko doubt hai? Anybody has any doubt with this topic? Students?
No, ma'am.
So I will send the PowerPoint in the group, and if you have any doubt, let me know, okay, in the next class. And tomorrow I don't have a class with you. Tomorrow Prashant sir will take your class. So on Monday, okay, so Monday I will take your class, and all the topics that I have done from Monday till today. And on Monday I took your class, Tuesday also I took your class, then Wednesday was a holiday. Thursday Prashant sir took a class, and then today. So three topics, okay, and also last class, last week's topics also. So Monday I will take a test on all the topics. Okay, so I will the test will be on MCQ. Okay, so I will give you by Google Docs, okay, and it will be in MCQ questions. So there will be 20 questions, 1 mark for each question, okay. So this is a 20 marks test. Yes, somebody was saying something. Hello. Okay, so inform. Okay, so inform in the group last week's topics and this week topics. Okay, dono achhi tarah se padh lena, and Monday I will take a test. Okay. By Google Docs I will send you the link. Okay, just like last year we did. So I will send you the link, and then you will perform the test. It will be an MCQ, okay, 20 marks test. Sabko bata dena. Okay, so thank you.